Hi guys, welcome back to the new video of Easy Tutorials. Today in this tutorial I will show you how to make a tab layout on your HTML and CSS website. As you can see on my computer screen, here we have three tabs. When I click on the second one, it displays the hidden content of second tab, and when I click on the third tab, it displays the hidden content of third tab. The best part of this tab layout is its animation. As you can see, when I switch tab from one to another, first tab's content moves right side and another tab's content moves from right side to left side very smoothly. This is very easy to make this type of animated tab layout for your website using HTML, CSS and a small JavaScript. Before starting this video, please like this video and also subscribe my channel Easy Tutorials if you are new here. Now let's start this video. First I have one folder here, and in this folder you can see I have three images and one HTML file and one CSS file. Now I will open my text editor, which is brackets editor. So this is my HTML file and this one is CSS file. In the HTML file you can see I have added this line to connect HTML file with CSS, and here is the link for Google Fonts. And in the CSS file you can see I have added font family, this one. I have already one video on my channel how to add a Google font on your website. Next I will come to the HTML file, and in the body tag first I will create one div, and I will add one class name also. So the class name is hero. Now I will copy this class name and add it into the CSS file, and for this one we'll write width and height and position relative and margin from top 100 pixel, bottom 100 pixel and auto from left and right. Next I'll create one more div in this hero. So the class name is btn box. In this div we'll create three buttons, so I'm using button tag. Just duplicate this one, and now we have three buttons here. Now I will open this HTML file with Google Chrome so that you can see three buttons on this web page: HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Now just copy this class name, write it here, and for this class we'll add display flex and border bottom 1 pixel solid and this color. Let's copy it again, and after that we'll add button. For this button we'll add background, it will be transparent, and border none, and outline it will be none, then cursor pointer. And some padding. Next we'll add margin from the right side, and font size it will be 20 pixel. Font weight it will be bold. Reload the web page and you can see these buttons like this one. Next we will add icons on this web page. So come to the Google and search for Font Awesome CDN. Open this website and just copy this link. Come to the HTML file, duplicate this line and paste the URL that you have copied. That's it. Now again search for Font Awesome icons. Open this website, and in this search box we can search any icon. So I am searching for HTML. Click on this one and just copy this one line of code and add it into your HTML file. We can remove this part. That's it. Now we'll search for another icon, CSS. Again add this into the HTML file. Next we'll add one more icon here. So now we have added three icons for these three buttons. Let's refresh the web page and you can see these icons and button text. Let's copy this class name for icons FA. Before that, we'll add this class name, and here we'll add margin from the right side. Let's copy it again. Here we'll write hover dot FA. For the icon, we'll change the color, this one, when we take cursor over this icon. So now you can see when I take cursor over these buttons, the icon color is changing. Now after this div, we'll add one more div where we'll add contents. So here we'll write content for the class name. In this div, we'll create another div and the class name is content left. Just duplicate it and change the class name content right. So now we have two columns here. So in the first one, we'll add one title in h1. So the title is learn HTML. Now we'll add some text in p tag. So this is the text here. And after that, we'll add one button. So I'm using anchor tag here. And the button text is watch video. Now in the right column, we'll add one image. So simply I'm using img tag and the source and the image file name. Let me refresh the web page. You can see this title, small description, link text, and this image. Let me copy this class name content right, add it into the CSS file, then we'll add img and we'll set the width 350 pixel. Let's refresh the web page. Now you can see a small image here. Now we'll copy this class name content, add it into the CSS file, and for this one we'll add display flex and justify content, it will be center. Next we'll add text align, center, and margin 5% and auto. Let's copy the left column class name, write it here, and for this one we'll add flex basis 50%. Just duplicate it and here we'll write content right, and for the right one also flex basis 50%, and we'll add text align center. Refresh the web page. Now you can see this image in the right column and this content in the left column. This left content is not aligned properly, so let me come back to the CSS, and here we will change it to align items center. Let's refresh the web page. Now you can see left right content is aligned in the left side. Let's copy it here, then we'll add p, and for this one we'll add different font size and some padding. Refresh the web page. Now you can see a small font for this p text. Here we'll add content left, then a. For this anchor tag, we'll add width, then display block, and we'll add some padding and border radius. Text decoration, it will be none, and background color, then color. Text align, it will be center. Refresh the web page. Now you can see this button like this. So like that, we have created one content here. So let me duplicate it. This content will be for the second tab. Here we'll change the image and title. Title we will learn CSS. Let's duplicate it again. And this one will be for the third tab. Here we'll change content title. It will be learn JavaScript, and image. It is pick 3. So now we have 3 contents here. Right now you can see all these 3 contents on the web page. So we have to hide 2 rows from here. So let's come back to the CSS file, and here in this content we'll add position absolute. Refresh the web page and you can see all these three rows are overlapping each other, all positions are same. Next we will add transform translate x 100%. Refresh the web page and you can see this content in the right side, and there is horizontal scrolling here, so we have to remove this horizontal scrolling. So let's come back, and in this class name hero here we will add overflow hidden. Refresh the web page and you can see the descriptions are not visible here and there is no horizontal scrolling option. Next we will come back to the HTML file and here we will add one ID, and the ID I am writing content1. Now for the second one we'll add content2, and for the third one we'll add content3. Next come to the CSS file and here we'll paste this ID content1, and here we will write transform translate x 0px. Let's refresh the web page. Now you can see only first content is visible here, other two are hidden. Next come back to the HTML file. In this button we will add one ID. So for the first one I am adding btn1, for second one btn2, and for the third button btn3. Copy the first one, write it into the CSS file, and for this one we will change the color. Refresh the web page and you can see the first tab button color is changed, so it looks like the first tab is active. Next we have to add the click option so that when we click on the second tab it should display the second tab's content and it should change the color of the second tab title. So here we'll add onClick and we'll add OpenHTML. Just copy this one, and for the second one we'll add onClick OpenCSS, and for the third one we'll add onClick OpenJS. Just copy the first one and come to the bottom just above this closing body tag. Here we'll add a script open and close, then write where content1 document.getElementById, and in this ID we'll add this content1. Just duplicate it and here we'll change it to content2 and this one content3. Duplicate it again. Here we will add btn1, and in this field we'll add the button ID, just copy from here. Again duplicate it, and this will be btn2 and this is btn3. Next we'll add function and just copy and paste it here. Open HTML. Here we'll add content1.style.transform and it will be translate x 0. Just duplicate it and change it to content2, and here we'll add 100%, and for the third one we'll add 100%. Now duplicate this complete function for two times. Write it OpenCSS and this one OpenJS. Now change it to 100% and this one 0, this one 100%. Now here 100%, this one also 100%, and third one 0. That's it. Let's reload the web page. Now you can see when I click on the second one it displays the second descriptions. Now we'll click on the third one, it displays the third descriptions. Next we have to change the color of these buttons. So just copy it here, then write style.color and this color. Duplicate it, write it 2. and it will be black. Write 3 and this will be black. Now just copy it and paste it into the second one. Here replace with 2 and this one 1. Just copy again, paste it into the third one. Replace it with 3 and this one 1. Now refresh the web page. Now you can see when I click on the tab title, it changes its color. Next we have to add some smooth transition when we switch between tabs. So just come back to the CSS file and here in this content we'll add transition 0.3 seconds. Refresh the web page. Now you can see when I click on any tab, these descriptions are moving towards left and right. But right now both the contents are moving at the same time. So we have to add some delay here. So just come back here in the HTML file. Here we will add content1.style.transitionDelay. And this delay will be 0.3 second. Just duplicate it. Write 2, it will be 0 second, and for third one it will be 0 second. Just copy here, paste it into the second one. This delay will be 0 and this one 0.3. Again copy it and paste it into the third one. This will be 0 and last one 0.3 second. Now refresh the web page. Now you can see when I click on any tab's title, the description goes to right side and the right content comes to the left side. So this is how you can easily create this type of animated tab layout for your website using HTML, CSS and a small JavaScript. I hope this video will be helpful for you. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment section and please don't forget to like and share this video. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end.